dancing Yoshi. Let's go.
SGDQ 2023, can you hear me?
All right.
Awesome. I'm EpicYoshiMaster. I'm here today with my very favorite run, CrossCode. I'm joined here by one of my lovely commentators, May.
Hello, I'm Corvimae. I used to run this game, but it's really hard, so I stopped.
And also, we have a very special guest. Please introduce yourself.
Hello, my name is RD Regiden, or Stefan. I'm one of the developers of CrossCode.
This is going to be an exciting run, but we gotta get right into it. We're gonna start time in 3, 2, 1, go!
So if you haven't played this game is a 2D, like, hybrid RPG and dual joystick shooter is how I describe it to people. There's a lot of throwing orbs at things, which GDQ famously loves. And there's a lot of doing RPG things, and like quests and stuff like that. A lot of it, there's like a ridiculous amount of content in this game. There's so much like side stuff that you can do and things you can collect, and we're not going to do any of that. So right now we are not playing as the character we normally play as. It's the tutorial section over here. It's fully scripted. It's just teaching you how to do the different moves. The one thing that we can do to speed up time here is that we can dash. You can dash 3 times in a row before you then get on a cooldown until you can dash again. That will soon change, and then we'll be able to dash forever. We'll get there. So now this is the part where it's a dual joystick shooter. You use the right joystick to aim, and you use the left joystick to move, and then you shoot. You all know how video games work. So this is more tutorial section. But we are going to immediately start skipping stuff, as you're supposed to do this puzzle here. Oh.
That didn't happen. You didn't see anything.
You're supposed to do this puzzle here.
Oh. Wait for it. There we go.
Puzzles take time. You don't want to do them. Also, you know, I said this game is a hybrid dual joystick shooter and RPG. It is also a puzzle game. There are so many puzzles in this game. They get very difficult, especially the DLC. The DLC puzzles hurt my brain.
We did our best.
All right. We're going to skip this. Yoshi?
There we go.
Yeah! So, although this is a 2D game, it does exist in 3D space. We're going to be taking advantage of that a lot. Anybody but me on this run right now can explain how that works mechanically better than I can.
I do think we have a professional in house.
I have heard this.
Yeah, what can I say? You're already playing better than we test the game, right?
So these rats we do have to kill. I'm sorry, Remy. Sorry, Chef. Forgive me, Chef. And now we're going, so you can charge up a shot and then it will bounce for a little bit, which we can use in this to essentially, we know where these things are gonna spawn. So that's, you do this so much better than I do it. I miss all of them. So that's just some extra damage and that saves a small bit of time. We are slowly gaining more abilities as this goes on. Which I believe we have the shield now, right?
No, we don't. Not yet.
Man, I.
Forgot about it. This is a fun fact. We actually really forgot about that to introduce that, and so we made it out of the story.
We could have saved more time if we had it earlier.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. We forgive you.
Thanks.
Okay. And now, oh yeah, you don't get it until the, yep.
We got some story first.
Yeah, we gotta do some story. I have a quick question. Does anybody know what an MMO is? We're about to be asked that question by our good friend, Sergey.
My answer's yes.
Good. Because this game is an MMO, but not really. We are not currently connected to the internet. We managed to play an MMO offline. It's pretty impressive. Technology has come a long way. This is a game about playing a game. We are playing in the futuristic MMO cross worlds, which uses like instant matter tech stuff to create a world that you play with through your avatar character. So you're gonna see like other NPCs running around. Or other, no. They are NPCs, other players running around. All right, we're about to get the shield here, because once we dodge these two things, you can get hit and lose time. I've done it. It's very sad. You have to get hit there, and now we're like, okay, well, now we have the shield. And the shield is really good, because it allows us to dash forever. If you dash and then you shield between the dashes, it like resets the count. I don't know exactly how it works behind the scenes, but we can dash and keep dashing and dash, and that is going to be our main movement like across like the overworld for this entire game. So you can see, well, first we got to fight a crab. It's time for crab. So this,
as you do,
this fight has a quick kill. What's cool about the quick kill for this fight is it's random. you can do
first
it.
First kind.
Yeah, you can do it in one phase. Essentially, what's going to happen is Yoshi is going to get onto the crab, is going to try to do, I believe, 596 damage-ish, as close to that as possible, then fire a shot below, and then keep hitting it, and then needs to do a dash in a two-frame window, forced it to not get it.
It's really hard.
It's really hard. Because you'll be able to like iframe the knockback there.
And even then, even if I get that, I need enough critical hits to actually get to the next phase. It's about a 1 in 3 if you're perfect.
And as a bonus, it is possible to crit too much before. All right. Does the world record currently have crab?
I believe so.
It does. Okay. For a while, it did not. The world record for this game is absolutely absurd.
Huge shout out to Simp.
Simp is unreal good at CrossCode.
I did not know this works.
I didn't know it until I was like, I was learning the game, and Simp was like, "Oh yeah, there's the strat. You should not do it unless you are going for world record. Do not do this strat." So now we are doing like an escape sequence where that guy over there, the designer, was like, you're not supposed to be here. I'm taking you back. And now we're trying to escape because he's summoning all these robots. We can skip some of it, or we can get like pretty far ahead. The last room, I believe, is the one we have to wait in. Which means we can do some Leia spins. Yeah.
It is Leia Spin Tuesday.
It is Leia Spin Tuesday.
It is true.
In the year of CrossCode.
It is also the year of CrossCode. This game has had a ton of development over the last year. Just they've found a ton of stuff that is extremely cool, and we're going to be able to show off a whole lot of it. Don't fail rookie jump.
Woo!
That's not rookie jump.
But I didn't fail the first long jump.
Is it not? I always thought that's what people
no,
were
No, 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 no. That's the really hard one.
The hard one's so easy to fail, though.
But yeah, that's why it's the really hard one.
So every time we attack here, you notice that Leia does 3 attacks, and then we'll do like a spin attack. If you dash out of that spin attack, you actually stop the end of the animation early, and that allows us to attack faster. So we're going to do that a lot. Yoshi has actually made a ton of training, like speedrun tools for this game. One of which is a little timer that'll pop up and we'll be like, you were 3 frames late, get better.
Wait, that exists?
Yeah. The stuff Yoshi's made for this game is like so cool and I wish it existed and run it. I hate this room, it's the worst room in the game.
Let's go!
That was first try, so.
That's really hard.
It's so hard. I've spent so much time trying to learn that room and I never got good at it. I cannot do it consistently. This room, we're supposed to go all the way down to the bottom and do a whole other set of puzzles. That's low. We're just gonna ricochet balls off walls. All right. We're about to get. We now have unlocked the ability to put on equipment. So you have two. Because this is an MMO in real life and definitely for sure, you have 2 levels. You have your gear score and you have your actual level. Gear is really, really important in this game. If you're playing it casually and you're having a lot of trouble, you probably need to go upgrade your gear.
A thing that we intentionally did to help speedrunners.
Oh, sweet. I didn't even know that. That rules.
We appreciate the help.
Yes. Especially me. I need all the help I can get running this game.
Also, you don't have to grind too much. That also.
Yeah, it's great.
It's really nice.
So a lot of the rooting in this is around getting access to certain items to boost our gear score for certain points. Okay, so this fight, there's like a whole bunch of stuff supposed to do about ricocheting balls around it to hit it when it goes into its immunity mode. Instead, we're just going to sit on this platform, and then we're going to walk behind it. All right, we need quiet time. It doesn't know we're here.
Don't tell them.
So once it's done with this attack, you see that break? I think every enemy in the game, correct me if I'm wrong, has a way to break it, which puts it in a vulnerable state. And you do more damage when it's broken. Sometimes enemies take significantly less damage when they're broken. When they're not broken, they always take more damage when they're broken. Also, we've leveled up. We're not supposed to be able to do... We have too much experience in the plot of the game because we fought the crab. And that's going to come up later because we're... You know, we're speedruns. We cheat.
We're cheaters.
All right, so now we have circuits. If you ever, y'all have heard of the sphere grid? It's a lot like that. There are there's a giant web of passives that you can skill up. It's the giant skill tree, and it also gives us access to arts. There are four types of arts. Okay, hold on. Yoshi's gonna do a skip on this. We're not supposed to get past this border yet, but what we do is we dash past it. And then we turn on the tutorial, and then we turn on skip tutorials again. And so this tutorial skips the overrides the animation of it bouncing you back behind the barrier. We are extremely not supposed to be here.
This is like the last main area of the game. If we fight any of these, we would just die in one hit.
Yep, but it's fine. They're calm. They're just some calm little bugs.
They're vibing.
So there's four types of arts in this game. There are dash arts, guard arts, throw arts, and melee arts? Are they attack arts? What's the proper term?
Yeah, that's right.
Nailed it in one. You can charge...
Hey, what happened? I didn't look for 1 second.
Yep. So that prompt that came up was asking us if we wanted to fix our save, because this game was... There were a lot of builds earlier on when this game was early access, or was it beta?
Both. It's early access and beta, I would say.
And so as they made changes, they were like, okay, well, this seems wrong. We can fix your save and return you to where you should be. We are sometimes going to take advantage of press yes, because it fixes things, and we are sometimes going to say no, because we need to not be warped to a place that loses time. That was a place where we say yes, because it puts us where we need to be to progress.
I think now would be a great time for some donations.
Yeah, go ahead.
No, absolutely. I got you covered. We have a $25 donation from R2JL that says, hi, Leah. Hi, bye, Chef. Bye, Chef. Thank you very much for that donation. We've also got a $25 donation from Marcy that says, Leah, hi! Literally just finished this game for the first time a couple of days ago. So excited to see someone beat it in a fraction of the time. And a quick update, we have met the Bastion bonus any percent race incentive, everybody!
Woo, let's go!
Thank you very much for making that happen and helping unlock even more GDQ. Do you have time for more?
I think we'll stop for now.
All right.
So yeah, that area right there, you used to like go all the way down a bridge and then shoot the two things off screen by lining up your shots perfectly. It turns out you can just do it without walking all the way down from like the same spot. And that was fun this year, right?
Yeah.
We used to just lose time for no reason. We're gonna do some shopping here. And now we're going to explain the category here. So this is CrossCode Any% NMG, which means no menu glitches. And that's because you can stack menus in this game and mess up the shops in ways that do very bad things to what RD intended. So this category does not do that, because that category is like 30 minutes... And it's pretty much just a lot of menuing, and
I think this is the best category of the game because it's a cool mix of showing off a lot of cool strats, a lot of cool tricks, while also getting to see like the game.
A little bit, yeah.
All right, so we are currently on a shopping run, but for free. We're just running around, we're grabbing chests, and we are now going to do some our one and only grinding section of the game. We have to get to a certain place to trigger a plot flag, essentially. And while we do that, we are going to use the dash art first cut through these enemies. It will kill them immediately. Now, we used to just do this three times, but there was a reroute recently. And by doing that, you are 6 experience short of where you need to be. And so now we do go out of our way a little bit to go hit some things. I hit 3 different of these hedgehogs over here. And because we still have to wait for that NPC to run to the end, we don't... If you do it perfectly, you don't lose any time. And you usually don't lose... You lose less time than you gain by doing the reroute, essentially. It is just very funny that at the end of the run... You are 6 experience short on the old experience route, so you need to beat up like one thing.
Sounds like we need to increase some XP gain, huh?
See, yes, but then we can't do a trick that's important later. So you win some and you lose some.
Mm.
All right, so we are going to do a buffered dash art here. We're going to dash. We're going to buffer it there. We're going to use just water here to cancel the all of our momentum.
What?
Yeah. That allows us to dash very far horizontally without losing momentum as much, which lets us get over to places that we don't need. I hate what you all did to this room.
I'm curious what you think of this solution to this puzzle, RD.
So we used to do this normally. This is so cursed.
Oh, wait. Right here. There we go.
Developer intended solution, I'm sure.
What? That is very creative.
Yeah, that's a very nice way of putting it. I agree.
It is a room that we regret to put in that early because it was a frustration point for many, but that's a very creative solution.
Yeah, there was a night where a bunch of us in the CrossCode community like just spent a day just looking into dumb ways you can solve that room. There's a whole lot of stuff you can do there.
So that right there, because we jump up in the air, we do get a little bit of vertical height. And by doing a spin dash, or spin jump, which is a slightly... If you jump off and then you attack and then dash, you will go further in the 2D space. Explaining a 2D game that is actually 3D is hard.
It's making my head spin.
It's making my head Leia spin.
You could say this game has many layers, right?
Yeah!
Oh.
It's like an onion. As we saw in the last game, quite a lot. You can probably do a donation while we do this.
Absolutely. A lot of love is pouring in from the CrossCode community. We've got a $50 donation from Fabian that says, CrossCode is one of my favorite games ever, and I can't recommend it enough. So, of course, I had to donate during it. Much love to the devs, runners, and GDQ for showing off this amazing game.
So this room has a faster strat, but I believe it only works at extremely high frame rates. Is that right?
Yeah. There's like a really weird strat where at the very beginning of the room, you can like buffer a dash to get the bomb on the platform right away, but it requires really high frame rate, and so we don't really want that in our run right now.
Yeah, it's not currently allowed. You can do one more.
Yeah, absolutely. We've got a $25 donation from Shelty that says, let's go, Yoshi! I'm so excited to watch your run. I wish I could have stayed the whole week and watch it in person, but I'm cheering you on from work. Please don't tell my boss.
Thanks, Shelty.
All right, so this is Digmo. If you do this fight well, then you kill him really fast, and if you're me, you do it really slow. That was so good.
Wow.
Every fight in this game is highly choreographed in the run. So if you do the same things every time, you will for pretty much always be good. But the problem with that is that execution. Man, that's hard. This is new. We used to run on the fence. That is, in fact, faster.
Yeah. defense one I knew. This one is new to me as well.
This is just a room where we're going to do a fight. Every time there's that red thing in the middle, we have to kill some things, so you can do another one.
Absolutely. We have a $75 donation from Tofu Raven that says, CrossCode, yay! Sadly, I can't catch more than a glimpse before heading out, but I do have a great run crossing those worlds.
I lied, you can do two.
All right, we've also got a $50 donation from Teflora that says, Year of CrossCode! Thank you for making this run happen on the big screen. I was hoping to witness this one day. Best of luck with your run, and hi!
Thanks so much, hi. Teflora.
So you're gonna see a lot of, you're gonna get a lot of donations in that are just saying things like hi, bye, and Leia, etc. And that is because in the plot of this game, Leia's voice speech engine for her avatar does not work properly. And so our friend Sergey is like coding us in more words. So Leia only speaks, it can only speak with certain like key words essentially. So there's a lot of saying hi to people, a lot of saying bye to people, a lot of saying Leia. It's very cute. Please play this game. It is so good.
So good.
Thank you. Thank you. Also, Teflora is our sound designer.
The sound of this game is also very good.
And yeah, the sound note. The one who just donated, Teflora, is our sound designer. Or was a sound designer on CrossCode.
Alright, so
I see you in chat.
So you see these little orbs that have the fire in them. That means that when you fire a spheres through them, they will become fire spheres. There are four elements in this game. Fire, ice, wave, and shock. They all interact with things in very different ways. That is why this game is secretly an extremely hard, difficult puzzle game in disguise. This is a new thing that they discovered this year. This is there a name for this trick?
Bomb warp.
Bomb warp. We're going to warp a bomb. So we're going to fire a bomb, and when the bomb, if we exit the room as the bomb goes off, it carries on the explosion force over the transition, and it will blow up a rock in the next room. The timing is pretty tight, but there's cues for it. So we used to have to wait. This room used to take so long. You just have to wait for the cat to do the things you want and throw a bomb, and then you beat up the cat, and it was three different segments. But instead, by doing a bomb warp, you blow up the last two. You just have to have it have one bomb. You blow it up with the bomb. That's the entire room. It saves so much time.
That is amazing.
That cat has killed me many times.
we once saw this particular glitch, and we were actually amazed that this works.
That's every time that the community finds a glitch, I'm like, what? You can do that? This is Corrupted Digmo. We got to beat up all of these little bugs, and then we're going to do a bunch of damage to him, and then we're going to go behind him, and we're going to break him. We're going to use Spear Saw here a bunch. Spear Saw is a combat art. I think that's what they're called, right?
Yeah.
And Spear Saw also puts them in a lock state. So we'll be able to keep, if done correctly, that was really good. Then we're able to get that kill in one phase. It is very important that we kill him when the bugs are out because we need the experience from the bugs. So now we have our very own fire element. We can press down and now we become fiery hot. Each element has its own arts that you can skill up, and each element also has its own skill tree. So your stats actually change depending on what element you're in, which is something that that is going to become very important later. This has been a very good segment right now, I will say. This has been really clean.
Why do you have to say that?
Okay, well, this was really clean.
You jinxed it.
We're going to use our last cup of water here. Stay hydrated.
Stay hydrated, everybody.
To avoid flying off that here. And this is just going to be another choreographed fight sequence, so if you have a couple donations.
Absolutely. I have one that I think you are really going to enjoy. We have a $1,500 donation from RJB that says, this game is such a unique and fantastic masterpiece. Can't wait to see all of the skips and tricks Yoshi pulls off.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thanks.
We've also got a $25 donation from Anonymous, which I want to remind everyone it's crucial the amount that they're giving, because we have a segment of prizes that will be closing very soon after our next run, Hi-Fi Rush. So please go over to the prize page. Make sure that you go and check out the amazing prizes that are there. A quick example for you for that $25 donation, minimum donation, would be a new still-wrapped collector's edition of the very game that Yoshi's playing right now, CrossCode. So if you are enjoying this run, make sure you head on over, donate that $25 minimum dollar donation, and you too can be entered to win that collector's edition CrossCode.
I'm going to explain a couple more things, and you'll have some time for some more. So right there, you might have noticed that some text on the screen appeared that said limiter is enabled. That is another mod that Yoshi made for this game, because that skip that we do to get past the barriers that I explained earlier by turning on the tutorial and watching the dash art tutorials, for a while we thought it was like, oh, well, you have to have like be really precise and then if the timing really matters. No, it turns out it just depends on the frame rate. So she developed a mod to make the frame rate consistent for what we need in those parts, and that is allowed for the runs. And it's made that trick essentially not random. We all just thought we were bad. So we're gonna go grab some, so at the end of that, we got opened a chest, and that gave us the first key. Is that the white key?
It's the, not that one.
Okay.
The other one.
It's one of the three.
It's the bronze one, right?
Yeah.
The bronze key. So that lets us open up all the bronze chests. And so we're going to use that to grab stuff. That's the only reason we have to go further after getting flame in that dungeon. So while we're doing that, if you got some more donations,
make them happen.
But that's illegal.
I
that's
do
the
have...
longest puzzle. You just skipped it.
I don't even think I solved this correctly casually. I'd like to apologize.
I was going to say, was that developer intended to? We've got a lot
no.
of donations coming in for CrossCode. Lots of support here. We've got a $50 donation from Sparkle Brother that says, props to the CrossCode soundtrack composer. The music is so great and perfectly matches the mood of the game in the different areas.
Keep going.
We've also got a $50 donation from Tika that says, shout out to the best dev team I could possibly be a small part of. Awesome to see this game at GDQ. And then finally, we've got a $100 donation from Polymono that says, I've been playing CrossCode since release, and it's so nice. I bought it twice. The DLC is amazing as well. Just wanted to thank regiden for such a great game. I still can't believe that it's written in JavaScript. Oh, and hi, Leia.
Yeah, this is secretly a browser game.
Yeah, it is.
If you couldn't tell.
It's true.
I also bought this game twice.
Thank you very much.
They did a steelbook, and it's sweet. All right, so I hate the maroon tree. I hate the maroon tree so much. We're going to beat up a bunch of worms. Yoshi, you know any facts about worms?
I don't know. I don't know one yet. Maybe give me a moment. I might come up with one.
All right, well, if you can't think of anyone, Citron will, our friend here, will just tell us worm facts the whole time. You know they have four hearts?
I actually have five hearts.
Crap.
I want to get that fact checked.
I really thought I had a bit going there. Then I didn't check my sources. That's on me. So this part here is not too bad. It's the last part. Oh. Please hold. All right. This part here is not too bad. We're just going to beat up these worms. The important thing here is we do have to be pretty quick because we need to keep our spicy bun going. Because I never explained food. Food, as invented in the 2007 GameCube game Ratatouille, is a thing that you can eat. And what... wow. So in the quick menu, you can go to the food menu, and it gives you certain buffs, and there's a cooldown, so you can't just use it all at once. That's food. So the spicy bun increases our attack damage. And so we use those a good bit, especially in the early game, and especially in the late game when we get access to backer food, which is very good. All right, so this is the last set of worms here, and then we'll be able to go downstairs to do the big one. And that's the fancy worm. So the thing that makes the worms the worst, and I hate them, is that they fire rocks at you, and you know a fact about rocks that worms fire, Yoshi?
They're homing.
Yeah, rocks home. That's a fun fact about rocks.
As they do, you know.
So our goal for this fight is we got to beat up this this worm because that will lower the platform. And in the second phase, we have to beat up two worms. But we don't want to do that because that's really slow. So what we're going to do instead is we're going to beat up this worm. We're going to get up on the platform. The rock's going to knock you off because it always does. And then we're going to hit the worm, get it into break, and we're going to get it all the way down to right above the point where it's going to break. And then we're going to get it at a very... Oh, you got Citron! All right, so the goal there was to drop four of those ashen mines because that will immediately do enough damage to break, and then the platform will lower again, and then we can just finish it in one phase. However, because we have an NPC whom we don't control, he can just ruin your life. So thanks, Citron.
Thanks, Citron. I'm helping. Okay.
This is definitely the worst thing Citron will do in this game.
Yep. Yep.
In the run pro... No, actually, it's just in general. Okay. So yeah, another homing rock moment there.
Oh my god.
I will say, I love this game. I do not know what you all were thinking about making the homing rocks in its platforming section.
Let's try that again. We get another shot. Maybe Citron will be nice this time.
I think the team is agreeing on this. Like, this is, we might have overdone it there.
I mean, it is, I will say, it was successfully difficult. But if you are thinking this game looks very difficult, this game also has incredible accessibility options, which is sweet. It's one of the first games that I think I saw that had just... This game is like, you can like slow down puzzles if you're not able to do them, execute them quickly enough. It's super cool. Is that going to work?
No, the bomb fell off.
Yeah. Unfortunately, all four of the bombs need to stay up on there. This fight is why I stopped running this game. I hate this fight so much. And it's...
Noted.
In the speedrun context, to be fair, and oh, it was also a skill issue, but... this is the first game I ever speedran, and it remains by far the hardest run I've ever
had. There we go.
This run is so difficult, and Yoshi is still doing an incredible job.
All right, there was a YouTuber that once said that we should have shipped our game with a beach towel.
I mean, I would buy a CrossCode themed towel. That's
awesome. I would.
Yeah, because the game makes you sweat so much. So yeah, it would make sense.
All right, so we have to do that quest to progress, and now we can go to where we. Oh no! Wait, hold on. I forgot we talked to the statue.
We have someone to meet and potentially have a little PvP with.
Yeah, so this game has PvP because it's an MMO, like I said.
Yeah.
And you might be thinking, but May, you said it was totally off online. Yeah, so this guy, Apollo here, because we have extra experience, he's like, you've shamed all Spheromancers everywhere. You're a disgrace. You're a dirty cheater. And now we're rivals. This fight here is... The phases are always the same, but if you do miss one, he will pretty much... If you mess up, he'll pretty much always get you. And so then you have to know the future phases. So this could take anywhere from 5 to 10 rounds. I'm a really good 9-round Apollo player, I'll say.
Nice parries. I love to see that.
Oh! Okay, cool.
Almost got me. Not this time.
So that was good. That was no lost really rounds. We will not be seeing Apollo again in the run. All right. So now this is like probably the long. This is probably the most puzzles we actually do with the game.
Considering this is like one of the only few temples we even complete.
Yeah. Don't worry though. If you were a little worried that we might still do things intended, come on. As you will very soon see, because we don't really want to go all the way to the other side, so we're just gonna do this.
Yeah, there's like a whole like bottom floor to this area. We don't need that. We just do this.
Perfect.
Oh, wonderful.
And just like that, we're already done with half the dungeon.
Yay!
Go to the mini boss.
All right, so this fight also has a quick kill. This quick kill is this is a very quick fight. If you get the quick kill. It's not that long if you don't. It's just essentially, and it's essentially you have to do a bunch of things in really quick sequence. I will try my best to do it. Like go auctioneer mode. So we're gonna get, now that we've broken it, we're gonna get it down to right about its break bar. We're going to go to the top of it. We need to build, make sure we build an SP there. We're going to drop an Ash Bomb. We're going to do a Ball of Steel. We're then gonna first cut through it and switch the flame, but I think something missed.
Yeah, one of the problems you can have with this fight in particular is you really need to make sure you're low enough on the health gate because your first cut needs to break him on the first hit. And in that case, I didn't really have enough time.
Yeah,
but that's okay.
If you do miss it, you know, it's not that long of a fight, fortunately.
Yeah. There we go.
Simph had a world record. When I started running this game, Simph had a world record for a bit that just didn't get Pinzo quick kill. It was fine because Simph's really good. You got some donations, though. That's also really good.
You know I get you covered, Corvimae. We've got a $100 donation from Kara is a Mime that says, "Hi Yoshi, hi May. So excited to see the Fatals represent on the big stage. This is my first in-person GDQ, and I am so happy I can help out in any way I can. Keep killing it and breaking games. And also, trans rights."
Trans rights.
Trans rights.
We've also, and I've been holding on to this one because I like this one. We've got a $500 donation from Blue Cheetah that says, "Hi, Leia. Hi."
Aww.
Keep them coming. We're just going to fight some stuff.
I'm saying that the community is really coming up strong with really big donations. Thank you very much for doing that. We've got a $250 donation from Lord Birch that says, "Excited for CrossCode. It's my favorite game of all time. Leia, hi."
Oh, I did forget to mention we can make ice now. All right, keep them coming.
I gotcha. We've got a $500 donation from Radical Fish Games that says, "Greetings from Germany. We're so happy to see CrossCode at GDQ. Thanks to EpicYoshiMaster and Corvimae for the amazing run and commentary. We also still can't believe how you made bombs explode off map, though."
That is new. I also was like, I'm sorry, what? You can just do that now? That's crazy. All right, we gotta get some keys in order to get past things. So, we're going to beat up some moths. This is it. If you don't like moths, then this is the segment for you, I guess.
Moth vengeance
not,
time.
Not Emily's favorite dungeon.
Yeah.
But this dungeon has my favorite combats in the game. You should quickly turn off the Steam overlay.
I'll need to know where to do that.
All right, so we got another key now. We also have that dash there. That saves a little bit of time. It's like, what, 0.02 seconds or something like that? I think is what, or something, I don't remember. Hey, we're doing some stuff intended. Nope. That was fun, doing stuff intended as it lasted. We're gonna get another key after here, after we beat up this guy again. It's a rough day for him, okay? Hey, there's the white key. I knew it existed.
Oh, yeah, at least you didn't say it was the silver key.
Yeah. That would have been really...
Internally, those keys are called bronze, silver, and gold key.
Oh.
Confuse everyone.
Yeah, that makes sense. We're going to beat up more moths, and now we have super moths. They charge up lasers, as all moths do. If you got a donation, though.
A particularly relevant one, Corvimae. We've got a $7.77 donation from Winbliss that says, "You don't understand, Leia. There's bugs with lasers. Bugs with lasers. I'm afraid of bugs, especially bugs with lasers."
Keep them coming.
We've got a $50 donation from Wervin that says, "It's great to see CrossCode finally getting the love it deserves at GDQ. I've been waiting for this since back when the run took 4 or something hours, and it's always amazing to see how that it's proved over time. Loving this so much."
So there, in order to get out of the room, if you save and reload, you will keep everything that you collected, but you will go to the like last entry point for the room you're in. So we use that to get out of the room. And now we have a safety save, so that's cool. All right, this puzzle also has a new solution, right?
Yeah, this is very, very, very intended, as of course. You only push one block, and then you just kind of shoot over here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Very intuitive.
Yep.
And then we're gonna do it again because we need to open that door in the bottom right. Perfect.
Yep.
A very often missed chest, we noticed.
Yeah, I don't know if I knew about it. This is just so these puzzles we're doing intentionally. So give us some donations. Intendedly. Okay, go.
Absolutely. We've got a $50 donation from Sierra that says, this CrossCode run is amazing and the commentary is fantastic. Is there a more iconic duo than GDQ and making my wish list increase? I feel you on that. This is definitely going on my wish list.
It's so good. So when I was looking to get into speedrunning, the way that I picked what game to run was I went through my Steam most played list and I scrolled down and I looked into the different runs and then I saw this run. I'm like, this run's really cool. And it's only an hour and a half, which as a Pokemon runner now is actually still pretty quick. But I didn't know how hard it was gonna be, but I just literally picked this game to start running with because it's so good.
No, thank you.
All right, so now we have another... No, wait. Is there one more key?
We've got one more, yeah.
Yeah. I was like, I'm pretty sure we got to go beat up some crabs.
Not crabs. Scorpions.
Are they?
Yeah.
No, they are. I'm dumb.
We already beat up the crab. That was at the
start. I know, but you know what? I think... I always think of them as little Heracrosses, I think, which is also isn't either of them. So... This room's fun because you just dash through everything. I think this fight's really fun. You just slide around the room. And now we have our final key. And now we get to do the long puzzle.
The big puzzle.
The big puzzle. So every dungeon has a big puzzle?
Yeah. We just don't really see most of them because we don't finish them.
Yeah, so we unlock all of the... I think we're going to do two of them. We unlock all of the chests here, and that allows us to get access to all of the different components we need to do the big puzzle, which essentially uses all of the things that you've learned in the dungeon, and you have to move the slow-moving orb all the way to the final thing by doing stuff in the big puzzle. They are very hard. The last one in particular took me a very long time to figure out. But it is cool that you could slow down the speed at which everything progresses if you are having trouble. We're going to beat up a ton of moths with Snowflock. Yeah, that's what the art's called. It's really good at beating up moths. There's a lot of moths, so I hope we got a lot of donations.
Absolutely. We've got a $50 donation from Anonymous that says, CrossCode is my favorite game of all time. Let the virtual ricochet projectiles fly. Really quickly, I just want to give everyone an update. In terms of the Returnal Tower of Sisyphus Phase 1 incentive, we have met it. We reached the $10,000 goal. And we have unlocked even more GDQ. And I want to just really quickly just remind everyone that we've got a couple of bid wars that you might want to take a look at when you go to donate. We have a High Five Rush incentive. Now, that's coming up after CrossCode. It's the Saver Drop Corsica bid war. Right now, Catch Her is in the lead at $503, and Let Her Fall is at $75. Everybody, Letting Her Fall saves an extra second for the run, so help Moist Rock out. Maybe try to get Let Her Fall ahead. Do you have time for more?
Not yet, but soon we will. So this is the boss of this temple here. If you all ever played Hollow Knight, it's like that. It's a big old moth. And so moths are weak to ice, as we all know. We essentially, it'll like fly into certain places, and then we launch a bunch of snowflakes into its big eye, or a bunch of icicles into its big eye. The one thing we have to watch out here is something I haven't actually explained yet, which is elemental overload. So if you look in the top left, you can see the little element like meter. And in the middle, there's a white, like a yellow bar that grows up as we use elemental attacks. If you get all the way full on that, you will elemental overload, which locks you in neutral until everything cools down. You can lower it by... I didn't know you could do that. You can... Actually, no, I did. You did it yesterday. I just forgot. You can lower it by doing attack... By hitting things in neutral or by waiting. So... You have to actually, it's in a lot of fights, it's important to make sure that you are not, you're watching that meter, because if you overload, then the fights don't work anymore, and we have time for a donation.
Absolutely. We've got a $5 donation from Airplane that says, Laser Bridge! I am eternally grateful for the existence of CrossCode, as it is easily one of my top five favorite games of all time. Sadly, I have purchased multiple copies of five for my friends, but none of them have played longer than 3 hours. Do I need new friends?
I mean, I didn't want to say it.
It's on my wish list now, so if you want to, no, I'm joking, you don't need to send it to me. I'll be your friend, though. All right, we've also got a $15 donation from Urenstein that says, Year of CrossCode. This fight sucks, though. Doesn't matter when you read this.
Honestly, in a speedrunning context, they're all so difficult. A lot of the reason why also why it's very difficult is because we are underleveled and undergeared for most of the game. There's a part where, like, there's fights that are, like, there's two temples that we do, like, that are next to each other. One of them's really hard, all the fights. One of them's not bad. And it's because we get gear between them. That, we used to think that was, like, sub-pixel perfect, and there were all these setups and things. It's just frame rate.
It's just the frame
rate. It's just frame rate. The other thing about frame rate is that if you play this game in 100, and if above 60 FPS, for example, you have a 144 hertz monitor, then it turns out some tricks just become essentially random, which we only found out because I couldn't figure out why I couldn't do them.
Yeah, the one May's talking about is called a dash flare, and
it's
actually going
up.
To become pretty relevant pretty soon.
We got time for one or two.
Absolutely. We've got a $25 donation from Crash Loves Danger, who says, so excited to tune into SGDQ and hear my husband, AttyJoe, hosting in person for the first time. The Corgis and I are watching and cheering on all the runners from back home.
Oh, woo!
That's my wife, Stephanie. I love you.
One more.
We've also got a $50 donation from, and I'm so sorry if I'm going to mispronounce the name, but Egerk, that says, so glad to see my favorite game here at GDQ. And it's even the category that isn't just looking at menu screens. Leia, hi.
All right, so here we're going to do a dash flare. The way a dash flare works is you dash, and then you do flare blitz. And then if you do it against the wall, then the momentum carries you a little bit forward, and you're able to get on top of the wall. And we use that to get to places we are not supposed to get to.
We tried so hard to not have that work.
And we are also now going to do another trick that is even more ridiculous, and this is called moon jumping. Moon jumping does not work anymore. It has been patched out. Y'all did take that one away from us, which is why we were playing on an old patch. So this is a status effect called Jolt, and Jolt makes you periodically hit yourself. So we're going to use an ability called Blizzard Hawk here. And it launches up in the air, and if you do it at the right time, the jolt, it's supposed to launch you up and then knock you down. But the jolt will override the knockdown, and we just are able to just soar up, move forward, and then soar up again. And that skips so much and breaks our save.
What? It's not okay.
I do like that. Sometimes we get to have devs commentate just to give them psychic damage.
It is very entertaining to see.
Oh. You can do one more?
Absolutely. I'll try to get two in really quickly. We've got $100 from Anonymous, no comment, and we've got another $100 donation from Anonymous with no comment. Thank you very much for your generosity.
I lied. Do the other one.
Three for one, then. So we've got a $250 donation from Bird Name Pat. No comment as well, but again, thank you so much, everybody, for your amazing donations.
All right, so we're going to beat up some fish. You can do another one. I lied.
All the donations, Corvimae. I gotcha. We have a $50 donation from Max W that says CrossCode is such a fantastic RPG. Speaking of fantastic RPGs, let's band together for Chrono's bonus incentive run of Redguard later. And really quickly, regarding that, the Elder Scrolls Anthology bonus Elder Scrolls Adventure Redguard run sits at $3,760 out of the $20,000 needed to unlock it. So please, when you go to donate, scroll down, hit the incentives, and select the Elder Scrolls Redguard run so we can unlock even more GDQ.
So this temple, if you hadn't noticed, is the Shock Temple. And so a lot of the things are about turning things on, using electricity to beat things up. Also, this room is the hardest room in the game. Would you agree?
It's especially challenging as a beginner to complete this specific room because it has a really difficult, long gauntlet of fights.
Yeah, it's like the hardest, it's not like the hardest thing in the game overall, but it is like the biggest probably barrier to beating runs in this game. This is the Trial of Persistence, and boy howdy did they name that one right. This is a gauntlet of fights, all of which, again, are we have to do very carefully, or else things if things get a little bit out of position, they can go very bad very fast. We also have to be paying attention to our elemental overload the entire time, because, there again, it's a lot of fights here. We also get one of my favorite enemies in this game, which is the octopuses with the happy cubes in them. Which we gotta suck those things out of them. Don't quote me on that. And then beat up some more fish. And then the hard part, the part that makes this really hard, I think, is the end. Because we gotta beat up some stingrays, which makes me sad because I love stingrays. But we wanna get them in a very similar position here, which that seems good. And there's also some knockbacks, so you gotta be careful. And then we were able to do that twice, which knocks them both out. And then we're going to beat up some more fish. And then I'm going to need you all to help count down from 12.
Count down every time you see a slime appear.
Yep.
12.
11.
10.
9.
8.
7.
6. 5. 4. 3, 2, 1,
-3. That's just the time that there. And now we have the Radiant Key, is that correct?
Yes.
And we get access to our very own shock. Hooray!
And epic metal.
That room is so hard, and once again, Yoshi made it look not bad, but trust me, it is really difficult. So now we have the Radiant Key, which lets us open up a bunch of chests. And we're going to do that to go on yet another shopping spree. I keep calling them shopping sprees. We don't actually buy anything. We do that later. We're going to do a dash flare up here to grab this pink, the Tengu mask. The pink petal was from breaking a tree. I was like, I don't know why we'd get that. That's because that's not what we get. And then we are going to read a donation.
Absolutely. We were talking about hydration earlier, and we've got a $10 donation from Gaius Van Belsa that says, "Such hydration! This is precisely our intention."
Tell me, Orzia, for whom do you fight?
Really quickly, I'm going to give you an update on the Returnal language choice. German is continuing to pull away, everybody. Currently sits at $729.12. French is in second place at $545. And Portuguese coming in at $130.73. Come on, French. I know you can make up that ground.
Do it for Emily.
True. True.
For her.
If you don't hit that switch before going up and doing the dash together, I believe you soft lock, right? Or, like, you get stuck. You have to.
Yeah.
You don't soft lock, but you have to teleport out stuff. We're just vibing. You can
one more.
More.
I gotcha. We've got a $50 donation from DavCloud that says, thanks for the amazing runs, recaps, and more, everybody. This is an amazing cause, and I can't think of a better way to celebrate my birthday. Happy birthday, DavCloud.
All right, so we're beating up some bugs there because we need to get a certain amount of SP. I don't know if I ever explained SP. You got bars of SP, and you use it when you use arts. As you get access to more... As you get further in the game, you get a bigger SP bar, which is important later. This fight used to suck, and now it's like really free because there's a new setup for it. You jump in the middle, you dash out of the way, you beat them all up. They all just die. It used to be so hard.
Goodbye.
This is what I always wanted people to do.
Really?
Dash out and then use a very strong art to take them all out at once.
We did something intended!
Yay!
All right, so now we're going to do the Wave Temple. They all have names that I never remember them.
This one's called Zervatar. Wave Temple.
A fun fact, all those names actually have a meaning.
Ooh.
Interesting.
I didn't know it was a full conlang. Wave, is mostly built around like teleporting. Essentially, so if we fire a wave shot and then it hits one of those orbs, it'll teleport us to there. This is where we start getting into the task flare zone, which is also a thing that is newer to being done not in a task. So a task flare is like a dash flare, which is the thing that we did to get up to like fire a laser beam and boost up. But you do it on a completely straight wall instead of a diagonal. It is frame perfect and sub pixel perfect, is that right?
Yeah.
So we need some quiet time.
That's
I don't
one.
Understand how that's possible.
That's one.
Wow.
It's not over yet. Wait. Let's
that's
go.
Unreal.
Wow. It was very impressive.
So that works. That's kind of the same way if you've ever seen a monkey ball run where they like pause buffer a lot of things to get to certain timers. It's very similar to that. The fact that you can pause buffer things is super useful. That is still absurd.
Yeah, there were already like a ton of variants for strats to skip in that area. I decided to make it harder.
Yeah.
It's fun.
It was not easy before. So doing that roots out a fight. And that's why we had to do that. I think I mentioned earlier where we were exactly 6 experience short. That is why the experience route needed to get rerouted. Also, how long ago did you incorporate that in?
Not that long ago.
It was pretty recent, given that on the drive up here, we were talking about possible experience reroutes. So, hot and fresh route for you here at SGDQ 2023. This is kind of like supposed to be another fight gauntlet, but now we have a lot better gear, so it's actually not too bad at all. But so, if you got some donations, that'd be pretty cool.
You know it. We've got a $20 donation from Zillia that says hi. We've also got a $10 donation from, let's see here, Hype Dream, which says shut up and take my money. Shout out to the dev team for making such a memorable game. We've also got a $20 donation from Will E that says CrossCodes is my favorite game ever. Thank you for talking about frame rate messing with tricks. Thought they patched them, but it turns out it was my new monitor.
There is a frame rate lock mod, which Yoshi also made, solely because I was like, I'm really tired of having to change my monitor settings to go down to 40 or go down to 60 hertz to play this game. You should make a mod, and then maybe I'll run it again, which I did not do. I hate this room. Done intendedly, it's fine. Done not intendedly, it's really hard. This is a strat that is also extremely. Oh.
I missed it. It's okay.
It's fine.
We got the first half. It's a really hard trick.
And like now you just do it the old way we did this, which is slightly slower. Oh no.
Yeah, like ideally you would get there in that single cycle. I would have made it onto this platform.
It's really hard.
Yeah.
Also, if you walk up too much after hitting those switches and go into the next room, you have killed your run. Because if you don't have a save earlier, then if you save, you're essentially stuck in that room and have to fight your way all the way out because you can't get out of the room because the room locks behind you. I have done that one. All right, so we're doing some circuiting here. Now that we've leveled up a bunch, we have a ton of CP, and also every single, your CP is, you have the same, your CP total, you have like the same amount to put into each circuit. So we have to do a whole bunch of circuiting pretty regularly in this game. We're going to beat up a monkey. This fight is actually really quick.
Fun fact about this particular dungeon is that there were two members in the team that wanted different things from the bosses.
Oh! And
so we ended up saying, well, we'll just put both of them in, you know? Much to the dismay of the one who had to do the boss.
Yeah. I mean, that makes sense.
He had to... Yeah, he was... You'll see everyone in a minute.
Nice.
It's in a very expected, very normal enemy you find in a tree.
So you might have missed it. We like wrong warped the block there, kind of. We were grabbing the wrong end of it. After it bounced off of, or after the wave hit the teleport orb, and then we were holding the wrong side, and that lets us just go into walls like in real life. All right, so we skipped most of those puzzles. And now we are going to go and fight.
No, we're not. We got to do a big puzzle.
You got to do the big puzzle. I forgot there's three big puzzles we do. So this is another big puzzle. Give us the donations.
You know it. I gotcha. We've got a $250 donation from Play-Doh that says, loving CrossCode and all the other runs. Saw this only on a casual play before. Great to see how it can be shortcutted during a speed run. Here's to more GDQ.
Keep them coming.
We've also got a $50 donation from Spiros Vondas that says, SGDQ, hype!
One more.
We've also got a $100 donation from Anonymous that says, this is the only game I've beat twice in probably the last decade. It's so great.
It's really good. All right, we're going to give a whale and a monkey. Because a fun fact about this game is that the development team, when they were building it, so that what attack the whale uses is random, so you can lose some time if it decides to go across, but we are going to one-phase the whale.
Maybe.
We're going to one-phase the... Yeah, I need you to have faith in yourself.
We are going to one-phase the whale.
Yeah! So we shock the whale. We need to then get it to a certain amount, and then we're going to fire a battery assault at it, and then...
Unfortunate.
Essentially, you have to, what's the other one called?
Radiant Swarm.
Thank you. You need to break it with Radiant Swarm and then have, no, with Battery Assault, then have all the Radiant Swarms hit it, yes?
You hit it with Radiant Swarm, then Battery Assault.
I got it so wrong. The monkey you still beat up in the same way. That one's not bad.
Yeah, the problem with the whale is something, you have to deal with critical hits, which can totally screw up the trick. You need to have Radiant Swarm hit and then have Battery Assault be the one that breaks the health gate. It's just a very specific thing and it ends up being a pain.
Yeah.
If you look at many of Simp's world records, you'll notice the description specifically says failed whale quick kill, and that's why.
I don't even think I'd even ever done it. I didn't think I know it existed when I ran this. All right. Hey, congrats on a trophy.
Thanks.
We got some time for a donation while we watch a cutscene.
All right, we've got a $15 donation from GM Big Kev that says, okay, y'all convinced me. I just bought CrossCode.
Yeah.
Game looks smooth as heck. I agree.
All right, so now we're going to do... Wait.
I'll see if you're right.
I was wrong. No, wait. No, yeah, we're doing tracking.
Yeah.
Tracking! Yeah. Okay, so there were those cutscenes before where you saw, like, an area that looked like this, and somebody who looked like Leia, but like a silhouette, walking in a certain pattern. We now need to do the same pattern for plot reasons. Oh yeah, also we skipped this. We used to do that with a another cutscene skip, but that is faster. Is that a task flare?
No. No,
that's
just a regular,
one, because you didn't buffers. There's no way it was a task flare. We're going to grab those because we need the money. And now we're going to go track. While we are tracking, we are essentially just doing a specific movement pattern. So if you got donations, now's a great time.
I've got a great one here. I hope I'm pronouncing their name correctly, but we've got Decay64, a $100 donation saying, "Hi, I'm so glad to see CrossCode on the big GDQ stage. Best of luck on the run, Epic Yoshi Master, and shout-outs to my good friends at Radical Fish Games. And shout-outs to Regiden. Hi, Regiden. And I'd like to remind everyone that there are two amazing CrossCode-related prizes available. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. I hear you loud and clear, Decky."
The CrossCode prizes are so good.
They're so good.
They're so good.
Donate.
All right, hey, remember this area? Remember the first area of the game?
Where we started.
Yeah. All right, so we're supposed to fight Shizuka here, who is who we were playing as in the beginning of the game. She's kind of important to the plot, but hey, you should play the game. We're going to just do a dash flare up here, and instead of doing Shizuka, we're going to do Shizuka skip. That was a lot of times of me saying Shizuka in a very short period of time. So now we don't fight her. She just waits over there. We do a cutscene. They sit under a tree. We read a donation.
I got you covered. We've got a $25 donation from Jordan97 that says, "With all the amazing skill being shown during this run, you could say that Yoshi is now an epic CrossCode master."
True.
And because we had the call on the last dono, I will let everybody know, for a $10 minimum donation, you can be entered in to win the Deck 13 Spotlight Digital Key Bundle, which includes three games, the CrossCode that you're watching right now, Chained Echoes earlier this morning, and Lunistus that's going to be on Friday. All three amazing games and worth being in your library. So for a $10 minimum donation, you can be entered in to win that as well.
Keep them coming.
All right. We have a $250 donation. Wow, the generosity from everybody. From X8, that is blank. It's nothing, no comment. But we are equally as appreciative. Thank you so much, X, for that.
This time we're actually going to go shopping. Like real shopping. We're going to spend money.
Keep them coming.
We've got a $100 anonymous donation with no comment. Thank you so much, Anonymous, for that. We've also got a $50 no comment donation from El Oso Gigante. Thank you very much for sending that over.
We're just shopping. You can come.
We've got a $500 donation from Let's Go, everybody, that says another wonderful GDQ.
All right. So this is a part coming up here where... More donations.
More donations. You got it, Corvimae. We've got a $50 donation from Evil Wraith that says, up, up, down, down. No, no. Just it, but no. Sorry, guys. Guess I got my codes crossed.
No.
We're not done. We're making it work today.
That's okay. I'm happy to be here. I'll give a quick update. How about this? On our incentives. Again, we've got the Elder Scrolls Anthology bonus Elder Scrolls Adventure of the Redguard runs currently sitting at $4,280.96 of the $20,000 that we need to be able to unlock it. We've also got our third bonus game that unlocked, which is Halo 3. That currently sits at $7,564 out of the $77,777 needed. So please make sure that when you go in to donate that we can help unlock the bonus game, but then also attribute it over to the $20,000 needed for the Red Guard run so we can unlock even more GDQ together.
All right. There are raids in the game that you do with your guild that you join. We don't do any of them. This is like the final raid, because it's what if the raid was real? Because it's like a storming the castle kind of bit. We're going to skip all the fights though, because that takes time.
Yeah, this section is actually really, really long. There's a bunch of triggers and stuff that's not happening here. We just walk straight up to this tower and go right into it.
And now we gotta do the tower. Sorry?
I was just saying okay.
Yeah. We're sorry. So the tower is a bunch, essentially there's a bunch of floors and there's a bunch of some fights on each floor. They are... So there's a lot to explain about individual fight mechanics. Those antiviruses are really annoying because, like, you gotta, like, make one neutralize the other. You can kill certain things if you if you're at the right place at the right time and then you charge up the right things. There are puzzles in this as well, which, again, if you're a fan of puzzles, I have bad news.
Sorry, we're going to do them very intentionally, as developer would like them to be. All right, so here's puzzle number one. We did it.
Woo!
Okay, all right.
Puzzle number
here's
two.
Puzzle number two. We did it.
Sure, definitely how we intended.
I'm so sorry.
Yep. It's okay. I love this.
If you get behind this guy, it makes him a lot less annoying. And if you don't, then it makes him very annoying. Now we're gonna go to 14.
Ready for some more puzzles?
I love puzzles. Oh, that was clever. I wouldn't have thought I'd do that.
Oh,
okay. Well, okay, that I actually. That,
this one's really
to
tricky.
Yeah. Okay. The spicy Beedo types that we're using raise our attack. And raise our health regen?
No.
I think
it's Brawler.
Is it? That what the green heart is?
I don't remember. It's something.
If I remember correctly, the backer who requested the specific item specifically designed it for speedruns as well.
Oh, that's super cool. See,
we appreciate it.
The food that we bought were made by Kickstarter backers.
Yes.
That's why we call them backer food. All right, so this is the quad turret. So the way the quad turrets work, you're supposed to beat up a turret, and then it'll give you a like an orb to get through the next set of it. But you're supposed to do it in two cycles. We only want to do it in one cycle, because that's twice as fast. So we're going to do certain arts in certain ways. Here we need to... There is a very small chance that you crit yourself there and lose your run. It's like 2% or something like that, as I think what's... I'm probably really wrong about that. I once watched Simp lose two world record pace runs in a row to critting himself on that. And then that was the end of that stream. This is a very long puzzle. So this is like the last one of the long puzzles, I guess.
The supreme puzzle for all puzzle kind.
And after,
the ultimate puzzle.
After that, we are just going to have a fight sequence and then the final two bosses, right?
Yeah.
So I guess we could start doing shoutouts now.
Can you go first? I got a puzzle.
You got a puzzle. You can do it in the elevator. You can go last. I just want to thank Yoshi for having me on this couch. Like I said before, this is the first game I ever speedran, and the hardest. The CrossCode community was super nice and inviting to me when I was just really new to doing all of this. And if it wasn't for all of them, I don't think I would be up here on the stage and have it be such a bigger part of my life. Because if they hadn't been nice, I probably wouldn't have kept with it. So shout outs to everyone in CrossCode.
Yeah, I'd like to give a huge shout out to the CrossCode community. They've been so inviting. They're so fun to talk with. Make fun strats with. Everyone's so great. I'd like to give a shout out to Frame Fatales, who gave me the opportunity to show off this run at Frost Fatales, which is awesome. And I'd like to give a shout out to everyone here in the audience
who's
made this run too.
And I would like to give a shout out to Radical Fish Games for making this fantastic game and being super cool and helpful to the speedrunning community.
Thanks, guys. Really, really, really nice to hear. We're super thankful for everyone enjoying the game, and especially this event for good golf and everything. Happy to see the game here, and thank you, Yoshi, for showcasing it.
Absolutely.
And absolutely breaking. I love it.
Wouldn't have it any other way.
Exactly.
We only see these enemies twice. They're called RNGs. And if you know anything about speedrunning, we want to minimize that. So we just
you eliminate them.
Yeah, we eliminate them. Use that one skill.
Ether snipe, which is really good.
I wanted to say Echo Snipe, but I knew that was wrong. And that just one shots him. And that is the last fight, the last thing on here. And then we're going to get into the designer fight, which is the penultimate boss of the game. There are two strats for this. I did the one that was easier but slower. Yoshi made me learn how to do it in order as I guess my entry fee for commentating. I did it zero times.
It's hard.
I will try my best to explain it. Once we finish circuiting, we're a donation while we circuit, though. That'd be cool.
I have a particular donation, corvimae. It's from corvimae. It's a $250 donation that says, "So happy to do my part for the year of CrossCode." Hi.
Woo!
All right, so this is designer. We need to use certain food here. We do one at the start of the fight and one before the fight. And then we need to get hit. We need to build up a bunch of SP because we want to fill our bar, because that'll let us essentially skip or do three of his health bars in the path of one phase. We also need our health to be low because that triggers an ability called Berserker, which if we're below 1/3 health, then we're going to do 52% more damage because that's how much Berserker we have. We use an ability called Guard Sphere, and then we use an ability called Battery Assault. Guard Sphere prevents us from getting our arts canceled, and Battery Assault will clear an entire bar if we're in Berserker. There's a lot of things to balance here. We are able to do it three times because that combo requires 4 SP to execute, which is one more bar per... That's better than the other strat because that one you can only do twice because that requires a 6 SP ability. But this is much harder to do than the other one. And as you can see how many health bars he has down there, this is like a very, very long drawn out fight. And by doing that, we skip so many of these phases. It makes this fight significantly faster. So if Yoshi gets this, I believe that will end the fight in 2 cycles.
But not the end of the run, we still got more.
There's still another fight. We still gotta do, because we only gotta get him to half for this. And then, all right, are you all ready for the ultimate experience? So this is
originally we planned to have 3 boss fights here. Thankfully, we decided to against that.
Thank you so much. We don't deserve that. So this is Crater. This is the final boss of the game. Our goal here is, once again, we want to get into Berserker. We need to cover our health flow, but we're also going to be using a move called Wave Motion Beam. And Wave Motion Beam drains your health to use it, and when you get to a certain point, it will end. So we have to balance those things. So we're going to use food to increase our health regen, and we're going to try to get in the sweet spot where we're getting the extra damage that we need from Berserker, but we are also not ending Wave Motion Beam earlier. And if we don't hit it, you lose a lot of time. If you want to see that, check out the FF run. All right.
And time will be coming up here, just to note.
Assuming that it works. We need to do it when he will cycle through all the elements. We need to do it when he is in shock because it will deal more damage. All right. We're going to jump off to get our health to a certain point. We want to get that, use the food we need to eat. We need to get the, we want to make that breakable as fast. We're going to use WMB and hope that it works. We're going to lower the volume here because the game does not like that we're doing this. And then...
time will end when that health bar hits 0, hoping this works.
Oh my god.
The suspense is always so much.
Come on, let's go.
HP region was a good idea, I see.
If this doesn't work, then you have a really long sequence where you need to get a button. It's looking good.
Time!
Right.
Woo! Woo!
Very, very good.
That was good. That was a good run.
That was fantastic.
That was a good run. That was a really good run.
That was a really good run.
Woo! That's CrossCode. NMG, any percent.
I hope you've all enjoyed. This is fantastic. I'm so glad to have had the time to showcase this game.
I'm so glad to have been
Thank
here
you
for
so
part
much,
of it.
Yoshi.
Epic Yoshi Master, quick question for you. What's your personal best? What's your PB?
It's a 116, but that's game time. See, I usually have about 3 minutes of loads. I'm not sure if that's a personal best, but
I have your
it's
PB
pretty close.
With loads is 1 hour and 20 minutes and 7 seconds.
That's
and
true.
And this is 118.35.
Let's go.
PB
CrossCode on the GDQ stage is unreal. I wish I was good at video games like Yoshi.
Congrats.
That is awesome. Do you two have any final words or any last shout-outs? I know you already did, but anything else that you'd like to add in there?
Keep watching the rest of SGDQ.
Yeah.
Awesome. Thank you very much. Let's give it up one more time for the amazing, epic Yoshi Master. Now, I don't know about you, everybody, but that run was so fast that it left my head Leia spinning. It's okay, you can boo at me if you want. We've got a $50 donation from Unstoically Dress that says, this is one of the best games I've played in a while. The movement alone makes it a blast, and I'm loving seeing someone do it better than I can. It was a great run. Everybody, please stay tuned. We're gonna head over for a quick break. Grab something to drink, stretch a little bit, and don't change that channel. Welcome back to SGDQ 2023, powered by Twitchin Live in downtown West Minneapolis, Minnesota. Thank you so much for inviting us into your home or being here live with us today. We've got a $100 donation from Quantum Jump that says 2023 is the year of CrossCode on the desktop. And after seeing that game run, I agree. I cannot wait to play it once I get back to my hotel room. That's going to happen. All right, everybody. We are ready to hand it over to the prize crew for an interview. Let's see what you got.
Hello, Chef.
Yes, Chef.
How are you, Chef? Whoa, that is fascinating. Okay. Hi, everybody. We are temporarily invisible, but it's fine. We can make this work.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we just want to talk about prizes, you know, like we always do.
Okay.
It's okay, Chef. I have you, because we have a whole restaurant filled of chef donations that I can still get through. We have a $500 donation from Chef Frozen that says, Chef, I tried counting how many chefs there were, but lost track somewhere around 230, so I just rounded up. Thank you, chefs, for this run. We've also got a $10 donation from Orange Cat Mom that said, I've watched a lot of GDQ, and this is my favorite run ever. We've also got a $25 donation from Chef Boyardee that says, good work, Chef. Good work on that dono, Chef. We've got a $10 donation from Moxie Chef that says, good work, Chef. Gotta say, Chef, this is the best run of the breakfast block, Chef. Well, it became more of a brunch, didn't it? We have a $5 donation from a confused person that says, am I a chef? You're not just a chef, confused person. In my heart of hearts, you are a master chef. We've also got a $5 donation from Remy the Rat, taking the time out of being a big movie star in order to give a dono, saying, hello, chefs, I'm happy that you're chefing with your fellow chefs while playing with me before I was a chef, Chef. All right, everybody, I got word that we are ready for that prize segment. I'm gonna hand it back over to you. Shout, what do you got?